Slicers in Power BI are being used to filter the reports. The greatest thing about slicers is that you can completely change their format. You can easily customize slicers based on the end user's requirements. Watch to the end.
Hello everyone. Xiao is back with another interesting video about slicers. Today, I want to talk about different types of slicers in Power BI and how you can customize them. But it is not all you can learn in this video. Stay tuned up to the end of this video and I will teach you an interesting tip that you can apply in your reports when you're using slicers. You can also follow me on LinkedIn, Twitter, and Instagram and read Power BI articles on my blog. Please like and share this video and subscribe to the channel to get the notification for the new upcoming videos. Let's go!
Slicers can be customized and we can change their format in Power BI, which is very amazing. I've worked with different visualization tools and each of them have a limited numbers of customization for slicers and filters. But Power BI provides the highest variety among all them. You can easily change how they look like. They can look like buttons, drop-down, list, numeric range slider, timeline, and hierarchy slicers. You can set different options for different needs. Look what your stakeholders need. Stay with me to learn quickly how and when to use these options. Don't lose this video up to the end to learn everything about slicers and a final cool tip. The first slicer type is list. We usually use list slicers to filter our visuals by a category. First thing you should do is to choose the slicer visual from the visualizations list. Then, choose a category you want to filter your reports, for example, product category name. As you can see, the default slicer type is set as a list for the text value categories. It means when you drag a text value field into the slicer visual, Power BI automatically creates a list slicer for you. Let's go to the list page, create a slicer, and drag the product category name into this slicer. Now you can easily filter the visuals in your page based on the list slicer. Let's have a look at formatting options. Within the slicer settings, you can see the style. For list slicer, you should choose vertical list option. Then you can see the selection. There are three different options available here. When all the options are off, it means you have a list in which you can choose one or more options. When you choose single select, the list options will be changed to toggle selection. It means you can only choose one of them at the moment. When multi-select with CTRL is on, it means that you can only choose one item at the same time. But if you want to select two or more options, then you have to press Ctrl button on your keyboard and then add the other selections. And finally, the Show Select All option, add an item to your list which helps you to select all the options just by one click. The slicer header formatting option will allow you to turn on or off the header, change color, font size, border, and background for the header. And the values option allows you to format the options in your list. The next slicer type is button slicer. If we select the slicer visual and drag a category field into it, automatically a list slicer will appear for you. Then, you should go to the Format Visual pane and from the Slicer Settings and Option menu, choose Tile. Now, all the categories are available in tile format, which is similar to buttons. All the other settings are exactly similar to the list slicers. For example, you can allow your users to choose only one option, multiple options, or multiple options by holding Ctrl button on your keyboard and adding select all option to the buttons. The interesting thing about button slicers is that this slicer type is responsive. It means that if you need vertical buttons, you can just increase the height of the slicer and decrease the width. And vice versa, for the horizontal button slicers, you need to increase the width and decrease the height. The next slicer type I want to talk about is drop-down slicers. Again, let's duplicate the list page and change the name to drop-down and edit the page title. Now from the slicer settings, change the style option to the drop-down. And that's it. Now you have a drop-down slicer and all the other options which are available for list slicers are now available for drop-down slicers. The next slicer type is hierarchy type. Let's just duplicate the list page and change the page name to hierarchy and the page title. Now if you drag the subcategory product name below the categories in the visualization field, you will be immediately notice some arrows will be created beside the list options. This allows you to drill down to the subcategories and select each of them you like. If you create a hierarchy slicer, two other formatting options will be available for you. You can increase or decrease the indentation. Just remain it as something that don't make confusion for your users. I think something more than 15 is great. Also, you can choose the expand collapse icon. It is automatically set on chevron, but if you like, you can change it to plus minus button or caret. So interesting. If you open the slide option from the slicer setting menu, you will see only drop down and list are available for you. So if you need to create a hierarchy slicer, you should choose either list or drop-down style. The next slicer I want to talk about is the numeric slicers. Let's create a slicer and add a numeric field to it. For example, I add unit prices slicer. Now you can see a slider slicer and you can change the slider to see the report for the product prices in the range you define. You can also insert the values manually in the range field. For example, I define the range for minimum $500 unit price and the maximum $1,000. Then you can see the report filtered for the products in this price range. You can easily press on the eraser icon here on top right of the slicer visual to reset the slicer to its initial range. Let's have a look at different styles available for numeric slicers. Previously, you could change the numeric slicer type from here, but recently it moved to the formatting pane. If I open the slicer settings, you can see the slicer style is set on between. It means that you can change the slicer between two values. If you choose less than or equal to, then you can have a slider which you can only choose the maximum value. The same if you choose greater than or equal to, you can only choose the minimum value. Also, the other slicer types, list, tile, and drop down, are also available for you to choose. But mostly, if you have a range of values, it's better to use the sliding slicer. The last type of slicers is the timeline slicer, which you may use a lot in your reports. To create timeline slicer, easily create a slicer visual and drag the date field from your dim date table into the visual field. You can see the same as numeric slicer, a slider created for you, and you can move the slider to change the date range. You can also manually enter the start and end date in the fields, or If you click on the calendar icon, a calendar will open up for you, and you can choose the start or end date for the slicer. If you have a look at the style options, we can see different types of timeline slicers. Initially, it is set on between, but you can change it to other types like before and after, or even list, tile, or dropdown. You can also see two other options. The first one is relative date, which helps you to filter your report based on a specific amount of time. For example, last 10 days, last 5 weeks, last 1 year, and even this week, month or year. The other option is relative time, and this option is applicable when you are using a date time field for the slicer. It helps you to filter your report page based on the hours and minutes. These are all types of slicers available in Power BI, which empower you to filter your visuals. But don't leave the video. And before wrapping up, I want to talk about a tip you may need in your report. And it's sync slicers. So let's describe it by an example. First, I duplicate timeline page, call it as sync slicers, and change the title. As you can see here, we can filter data based on different times. And now I'm going to the demo page, and here I create a button type slicer and use the product category names as filter options. What I'm going to do is when I press on the slicer on the demo page, this filter also applies on the sync slicers page. So, first in the demo page, select the slicer you want to sync. Then, from the View tab, find the Sync Slicers option in the Show Pane section. If you press on this option, a new pane will appear for you. As you can see, there are two columns in front of each page name. The one with eye or visibility icon shows which of the pages uses this slicer. For example, if you want to see exactly this slicer on any of the pages, like sync slicer page, you only need to put a check mark in front of the page's name. And that's it. You can see the slicer in the page you like, and you can edit and format it and use whenever you need. But you can see another column which is being used for syncing. So first I turn off the visibility check mark, and then turn on the syncing check mark in front of the sync slicer page. Then I should turn on the checkbox in front of the demo page. This helps to sync the demo and sync slicer pages to each other for the button slicer we use. Now, if I go to the sync slicer page, the slicer cannot be seen, but it is synced to the slicer in the demo page. Let me test it. Remember some of these numbers in the sync slicer page. And now I go to the demo page and apply a filter for some of the categories. Now if I go back to the sync slicers page, you can see this page also get filtered for the particular categories we chose.
Hope you enjoyed this video. Please like and share this video and subscribe to the channel to get the notification for the new upcoming videos. You can also follow me on LinkedIn, Twitter, and Instagram, and read Power BI articles on my blog. Have a good day, all Power BI lovers.